Now that we have a better understanding of the basics of sketching, let's take a look at some of the additional settings and options within my sketching tools, such as auto constraints, snapping to grid, and using guidelines. So first, we've just learned what constraints are. Now let's take a look at auto constraint. As the name suggests, this will do its best to automatically throw in constraints for you, so you don't have to do these manually. So, just as an example, to start, I'm going to make sure that my auto constraint is turned off. And here, if I just draw, let's say, a vertical line, notice that currently this line is in fact vertical, but a vertical constraint has not been added, so I would have to add that in manually, of course. And right now, if I tried to change, say, the angle of this line, I can do so because it has not been constrained. Now, just the same, if I was to turn on auto constraint and now draw a vertical line, it's just the same coming in as a vertical line, but notice now that also my vertical constraint has been added automatically, meaning that if now I try to move around or change the angle of this line, it's staying vertical as that vertical constraint has automatically been added in. So auto constraints are just very useful in saving you some time. So constraints will come in automatically while you're sketching rather than you having to put them all in manually. Now, of course, this might be a personal preference for you, as sometimes you may want the auto constraints to come in automatically to save you some time on sketching. But in other cases, you may want to sketch some lines and don't want those constraints automatically coming in, so you might want to turn auto constraint off. Another important option is the ability to change units. So if I just tap in my right-hand corner where I saw the views earlier, we can also change units. So of course I've been using millimeters for the most part here, but I could change to centimeters, inches, or so on to suit your own needs. A number of other settings or options are down in the bottom right-hand corner on the little magnet icon. I can tap on this. And here I have a number of great options. For one, I have snap to grid. Up until now, everything has been snap to grid for me, but I can turn that on or off as well. And let's take a look at what snap to grid does. So currently you can see I have this grid on my top view, and each grid space is 10 millimeters. So currently if I was to draw a line, notice that I'm jumping from one grid space to the next. So I'm only able to really count up by 10 millimeters at a time here. That's because I'm snapping to the grid. Whereas if I turned this snap to grid off, and now try a line, we can see that I'm no longer snapping to these grid points, so I'm no longer defined to that 10 millimeter snap, and I can really draw any line any distance here. So again, depending on your specific needs, sometimes you may want snap to grid turned on, and sometimes you may want it turned off. In addition to this, we can notice that as we zoom in or out on our designs, our default grid changes. So now that I've zoomed out, it's assuming that I'm drawing larger shapes, and now my grid is 50 millimeters. So if I was to draw a line, it is now by 50 millimeter snaps. And I could zoom out and in, and notice that up in my top right-hand corner, the grid values are constantly changing. If I'd like to lock in my grid spacing, I can do that as well. So if I just tap on my top right corner there and go to units, I also have the ability to lock my grid size at the current grid of 10 millimeters. And now I've locked in that grid spacing. So now if I was to zoom out any amount, notice it remains at 10 millimeters, or zoom in any amount, again, it remains at 10 millimeters. So you have the ability to lock in your grid spacing as well. Also, within our settings in the bottom right-hand corner there, we have a number of hide or show options. So we can hide or show midpoints, snapping points, and sketch or face centers. And also, very importantly, are the use of guides and guides on selection. And I have the ability to turn those off or on as well. So guides are just used to help me within my sketching tools. And we may have already seen a number of these purple guidelines coming in as I've been sketching here. And these purple extension lines or guidelines are just really used to help guide me within my sketches. So let's say maybe as an example, I was trying to move this endpoint of my second line here onto the extension line of my first line here. Notice just by trying to find that point within the grid or within my sketch might be fairly difficult. But what I could do is I could kind of wake up that guideline. So if I hover over the existing line, notice now I'm getting this purple square indicating that it's right on the edge of that existing line. I could also go right to the endpoint. I'm seeing an endpoint with the purple circle. And now if I extend that even past the original line, I'm seeing this purple guideline. And now it's nice and easy for me to throw this endpoint directly on the extension of my first line. So guidelines, as we can see, have many great uses, but I'll showcase this by just drawing a simple rectangle. Let's say I start my sketch here and just sketch down. Notice I have the guideline showing me what's directly down. And as soon as I hit one of my axes, my x-axis there, I have a guideline square showing me that I've hit that axis as well. And draw another line, again, a guideline telling me when I'm on my x-axis and when I'm right along that horizontal line. And I'll draw a line up, see my guidelines come in as well. And now notice once I hit the midpoint, I have another guideline coming in to indicate I'm hitting the midpoint of the original line. So perhaps I'd only like to sketch up to that point. Or I could keep going, and again, a guideline will tell me once I hit the first start point of my original line as well. And that's what I'd like if I'm just, say, drawing out a rectangle here. Again, drawing my final line to finish out my rectangle here. Sketch out, it's telling me I'm going exactly horizontal, hit the midpoint, and finally hit my end point to finish off my rectangle. Continuing on, let's say I draw another line here. I want to connect to an endpoint. I can even connect to the center of a sketch, or even just wake up that center point of the sketch and use a guideline to tell me where I'm dead center of that sketch or at some angle of the sketch, whatever I may need for my sketching requirements. So really, guidelines, as the name suggests, are just a great way to help guide our sketching tools. Now that we've learned guidelines and some more of the settings and options within Shapr3D, we'll take a quick look at learning how to use some primitives, and then on creating our first complete sketch.